stopping by this morning. We got so much to talk about and so much to get to, and a great audience here with us.
5:35 in the morning to come out here. All these things to do in Miami in the night. Maybe some of them haven't gone in yet. I'm not quite certain. I got a fellow over there with, it looks like, about a $25,000 gold chain. I feel like he's got a nice nightlife. This is a great crowd we've got out here. Appreciate these guys joining us.
Much appreciated, you guys.
There's some blood bling in that chain. I actually...
You tried to trade it.
I tried to
segment for the
one
chain.
One segment for the chain.
Yeah.
How'd that go?
I was
going to
wear mine.
You're still here.
You wanted him to pull it off just because you wanted him on the set.
Yeah.
Probably not public consumption. Time now for us to go viral. So the Chiefs arrived in Miami, pretty much in style, doing their best Andy Reid impression. With the matching Hawaiian shirts, there was another imposter last night with a media member showing up dressed as the 13-year-old Andy Reid from the punt, pass, and kick competition, which prompted us to dig up probably the most entertaining video we've seen in a long time. Andy Reid was just all around the same age, around age 13, with just
a little guy behind him.
Size advantage. Coach, what do you think?
There's no way my kid's going out on the field with that man right there. I'm pulling him off the field if he shows up at the game. I'm not doing it.
Priceless. The kid behind him can't even see what's happening.
Can't even see.
He goes, what? Tell me when you're
done. It's just always funny.
He could buy beer.
It's never not funny. It is never not funny.
I know it's coming.
Yes.
I've seen it 100 times.
Still funny.
And it's always funny. The little guy bumps into the back of him. He doesn't even notice.
How bummed out are you when you show up at the competition thinking, oh, I got a shot to win this.
No shot.
Yeah, then he's there. It's like, oh, okay.
All right, let's move on. Time now for some stories to start your morning. So last night, the Chiefs and the 49ers met for Super Bowl 54 opening night. And all-pro corner Richard Sherman said that he doesn't expect Patrick Mahomes to shy away from anything. Nick, will the Niners be able to slow down Patrick Mahomes?
Well, I don't think they're going to score touchdowns on 7 straight possessions as they did against the Texans, and I don't expect them to go on a 35-7 run as they did against the Titans. So that would slow them down a bit. I don't think they can hold them under 30, though, and if they are going to hold them under 30, Sherm's got to be great. I mean, Sherm, I believe, is building a Hall of Fame resume. I think he's on the cusp of almost locking in a Hall of Fame career. Another Super Bowl ring would do it. A big moment in the Super Bowl certainly would do it. We'll see what they can do.
Yeah, I think that the key is keeping him in the pocket. I've said this over and over again. They've got a great front. They've mixed in some blitzes, but they've got to keep him in the pocket if they don't want to make these explosive plays.
All right, moving on. According to our guy Jay Glazer, the Chargers are ready to move on from quarterback Philip Rivers. It was a rough season for Rivers, who tossed 20 interceptions, which was the third most in the NFL. Doug, what do you think? Should the Chargers move on from Philip Rivers?
What are their options? Now, I talked to Jay, and I talked to people with the Chargers, and Jay said it was taken a little bit out of context, a little bit of a throw in there. I don't think the Chargers have made that decision. This is a huge decision, because I don't think they really believe they're in the Brady sweepstakes. I do think they're eventually going to move on. He's so immobile back there. But don't take into account the fact he moved to Florida. He wants to play football, whether it's in Los Angeles next year, in Tennessee, in Carolina. He wants to play football. I don't think that they should, though. I think that they should draft the heir apparent and see. He had a bad year. He was awful. He cost them 4 or 5 games. They have a great football team devoid of a better offensive line with some help. I don't think you move on from Philip Rivers. I think you draft the heir apparent and keep him.
All right, you mentioned Tom Brady, Doug. Brady will be a free agent for the first time in his career. Another legendary quarterback, Joe Montana, he's advising Tom to stay in New England. Remember, Montana left the Niners, spent his last few years with the Chiefs. So what do you think, Nick? Should Brady stay with the Pats?
Yeah, I was really interested in reading what Joe Montana said, because he was talking about it from a schematic standpoint, the different things you have to learn if you go to a new team. But he was, to me, totally discounting the part of his career in Kansas City that I would think, for an all-time great athlete, was a absolute treat, which is he became a legend in Kansas City. I mean, to this day, like, people maybe outside of the city, people don't care, but it's another city where, I mean, I remember being a little kid and people being like, you know, Joe Montana's house is up there and they're giving out the full-size candy bars. Got the team to the AFC Championship game where they hadn't been in decades. When he posted the picture somewhere in his house, He's got a Chiefs memorabilia alongside his Niners memorabilia. So it was an extra nice chapter to his legacy. And so I was very interested to hear what he said. But when it comes to Brady, the problem for Tom is going to be this. They don't have the ability, practically, to give him everything he wants. When people talk about Tom going back to New England, they say, well, they will get him a tight end this year. They will fix the offensive line issues. They will add a weapon on the outside. And, oh, yeah, by the way, he wants a raise.
They'll pay him.
You can't do all of those things. And, Coach, you've talked a ton about how New England, historically, Belichick took a receiver in the first round for the first time since you guys were in Cleveland, right?
Yep.
So, okay, he took a running back in the first round for the first time in a decade the year before. Mm-hmm. Took a receiver in the first round, then traded a second-round pick for Mohamed Sanu. Do we think he's now going to quadruple down on skill position, high draft pick, or high free agent acquisition this offseason? I don't. So it would just be so out of his history. So I understand the argument of, well, if they fix all these things and give Brady this raise, then he should stay. But I don't think they're going to be able to or inclined to do all those things, which is why I think it does make sense for Tom to move on.
So San Francisco can make the jump from coaching in the Senior Bowl to being in the Super Bowl. But New England, who's 12-4, can't figure out a way to fix some of the issues that they've had. Like, to me, I think that's the wrong narrative. And one thing that Bill has shown consistently is his ability to adjust and to change and to adapt and to be ahead of the curve. And the advantage they have in New England is Josh McDaniels is coming back. Ideally, Dante Scarnecchia comes back. And for Tom, he can go somewhere else maybe have a really successful few years. But his best chance for success is in New England right now because he's not worried about what the scheme is. He's not worried about how practice is going to work. He's not worried about where he's going to park and where he's going to live and all those things that we take for granted that he will have to learn again if he goes somewhere else. His best opportunity to just jump back in, compete at a high level, and possibly win a Super Bowl is in New England with that group.
Yeah, I'm with Coach on this one. The first thing is in terms of Joe Montana. The most enjoyable part of you and I host national radio shows, right, is you get to talk with you. I'll never forget having a conversation with Joe Montana where he, to this day, is still ticked off that the Niners shunned him and gave what he believes is his fifth Super Bowl to Steve Young.
Sure.
So while you were experiencing, Kansas City was experiencing, we got Joe Montana, he's still ticked because he figures I should have had a fifth ring staying in San Francisco. And I don't think that's what New England would have if Brady left, right? They would have to start over, maybe go Andy Dalton then, right, and press pause for a year. But it's you're never going to recreate what he has. And Coach pointed out, they're 12-4. And you can say they missed on N'Keal Harry, right? But they had Antonio Brown, they had Josh Gordon, they had to get rid of them both within like a week. They had good enough players. They just had two guys that were troubled off the football field that they had to get rid of. Those type of players will still be available. And I do think that the best, tell me a better place. Like the Raiders? Give me a better spot. The Raiders? The Chargers? A Charger fan.
The Chargers.
Okay? The Chargers would be, that's like going to the Nets. That's going to the Mets. That's going to the second. Look, the Chargers are the fifth or sixth most respected and important NFL team in the city of Los Angeles. That's not on brand for Tom Brady.
What happens if you get Tom Brady, though? I mean, the idea that you don't totally remake what you are, at least temporarily, if you get the most famous, beloved, and accomplished player in the history of your sport, you do. What were the Clippers before Kawhi got there? Like, the idea
this
that
is not basketball. This is not basketball.
No, I understand.
Okay? It's not. You have a guy who's worked hand-in-hand with Josh McDaniels. The L.A. Chargers have a first-time play caller who got the job midseason. He's going to work with Tom Brady and install his complex offense that brilliant wide receivers like Mohamed Sanu can't pick up on the fly. That ain't going to work, dude. And, by the way, it ain't on brand to go to the second team in L.A. The Raiders are more popular. The Niners are more popular. Everybody's more popular than the Chargers. They can't. That would just be to sell seats, not to win games, and he's about winning games.
And one of the biggest mistakes that you can make with a great player or a great quarterback like that is to bring him in and try to force him to do something he's not as good at. Your best opportunity is to adjust your system to them so that they can perform at their peak level. And there's a little bit of time that goes into it. We saw it with Aaron Rodgers and Matt LaFleur trying to figure out where they fit together. And Tom doesn't have that kind of time. If he's going to be successful, he needs to go into some place where they're running his system. And there's not that many places like that.
No, you guys make really good points. Let me just check real quick. Oh, no, look at that. He still hasn't re-signed. So the owner wants him back. He'd be a fool to go anywhere else. The Patriots have said we need the
so why reportedly. Why hasn't he signed yet?
Can you check your phone? What's the date?
The date is what? I don't know the date. January 24th.
Oh, okay.
Something like January 28th. I'm 4 days behind.
Okay, so
we haven't even finished
the season officially.
No.
But Tom Brady hasn't signed, so he must be leaving.
Call negotiation.
So what's he negotiating for?
He wants more guaranteed years. Clearly more money. Okay. This is about money.
Okay.
This is about money. It's about
money and respect. And the team, when he was coming off his sixth Super Bowl championship, 1 year removed from his third league MVP, they refused to give him money, respect, or years. And now all of a sudden, when he's moved, when his house is for sale, when the owner has said, we want you back, and Brady has just put out cryptic Instagram posts, for one reason or another, he seems to be seriously contemplating dealing with all the upheaval,
In every negotiation, if you're not legitimately willing to walk away, it's not really a negotiation.
Correct. This happens in our business. This is clearing out my office. I don't know how this is going to go. I'm going to clear out my office just in case it goes the other way. Tom Brady's not playing for the Chargers. He's not going to end Johnny Unitas style in a Chargers uniform. He's not going to end up like O.J. Simpson in a 49er uniform.
Not Johnny Unitas or Joe Namath or Joe Montana or Michael Jordan. All-time great athletes would never end their career in a place we never could imagine them ending it, except more often than not, they absolutely do.
And Joe Montana told him, don't do it.
We're going to talk much more about this, but first, Nick, what's today's date?
The 28th.
See, numbers are hard. They're not always so easy. What did you say was originally? I just want to make sure.
That's not math. We're exactly the same.
Time now for First Rings First. Yes, that's what I said.
Take the L. It's okay.
All week, we'll be reliving our Super Bowl